But we'll play Fiji or Samoa in the semis. You know, two great sides. So we'll recover, or we'll grab a drink, and we'll get on with the next game.
Thanks and good luck.
Cheers. Next up, it's the Battle of the South Sea Islanders, Fiji, Samoa, to Samoa. Your commentary team, Ben Gollings and Nigel Stammersmith.
Yes, welcome across the world, all you viewers. And now something's got to give. One of the two favourites for the Cup triumph, the two South Pacific rivals, almost a tribal rivalry, who meet for the 55th time in the HSBC World Series. It should be an epic. They've met four times this season, two wins apiece. Samoa won the last two. They won in Tokyo 24-21, Vegas 14-12. And here they go. And, well, Ben Gollings alongside me. Pick out who you think we should be focused on here.
Well, I think the man who just kicked the game off, Wally Mai, the magician for Samoa. If he's not on the field, things don't work for them. He is key to their success today. And also Alafoti Fa-Silva, the guy, he scored over 120 tries, and he's a forward in this game. It's an incredible. But then you look at Fiji, they've got their new captain in Setefano Thakau. He has been a complete leader for them this year, and he's turned them around, and he's got them gelled together and playing like a team, and it's actually seen Fiji back to its best.
Wally Mai there, the 78th tournament for him, first Hong Kong, 2001. Two 33-year-olds of significance here, Wally Mai for Samoa.
Pause.
And as Ben says, Setefano Thakau, the captain, also 33. Two captains, two veterans, but brilliant players and wonderful talent. And of course, this is just a one-off between them. I know it's the Cup quarter-final, but, well, who's going to get the... Oh, look at this twisting herd. Absolutely wonderful play there by Alatasi Tupou. Now it's Fa'o Saliba, fed on wide by Lola Lui. And the break here is Ken Pisi. Terrific tackle coming back, but look at the support from Alafoti again. Into the hands of Lutu Mailangi. 5 metres out from the Fiji line. Each of them can run the length of the field. Naya Thalevu passes on to Naya Kandawa. And this has been a brilliant counter-attack, and Talib Mula, one of the four new seasons in this Fiji squad. Talib Mula, who made his debut back in London and Edinburgh back of last season, can walk in the opening try, the top try and point scorer of this season.
Yeah, as we see now, you knew it was going to be a spectacle, and that was some sensational rugby, end-to-end stuff. And Samoa so close, it was absolutely great build-up from them, great offloads, good support, but you can never say never against these Fijians. They get the turnover and they go the length.
26 tries this season, and there with, 77th conversion, and still a lot to go, but Fiji here determined to go back to the finals, which they had in Gold Coast, and they had in that magnificent final in Hong Kong when they beat New Zealand 35-28.
Beck.
Oh, knock on by Talib Mula there.
It's a big one for Fiji as well, because, you know, keep their hopes alive of a top slot at the end of the World Series if they go through again. They need to be in a semi-final to compete with New Zealand.
Yeah, remember that Fiji are just 6 points behind New Zealand, second place at 122, and that is the Samoan coach who's taken over from Stephen Beetham for this tournament. So this is his debut. He was the manager until now. Wally Mai to Ken Pisi. Just see the breakaway, Apai Iono. Terrific tackle back. Little tumble.
It's on here for Fiji. If they can just move the ball, half the Fijian team and still get back on their feet.
This is Lola Lui. Out wide is Autogambaya, but Lola Lui goes himself. Is tackled by Lutu Mailangi.
Side entry.
But Fiji are at six and sevens here in defence. Brave with that tackle there, and Autogambaya again. Samoa poised to come back. Advantage being played for Samoa. They'll take the try though. This is Apaiono wide out. Can't stop him. Apaiono, the man who was so much the understudy behind Trevor Anderson, Mikaele. has really stepped up this season, and that was a tremendous try, and the intention is coming up.
Leave it, guys.
Well, you can see the rivalry there at the moment, but I mean, these guys are flat out on their feet. You know, I think they've played a whole day of rugby yesterday, Nigel, and it's amazing what it takes out of the body. But yeah, and they come out here and they actually produce what they're producing now, the way in which they've got themselves back together. And that was a cracking finish by Samoa. I think there was a potential offside tackle there by Fiji, which would have stopped it early.
Got an injury to each squad here.
Okay, pass off. Yep, just come over.
Attention being given.
Come to me.
Courtesy from Setapana Sako, just to say bad luck. But Alatasi Tupu is up on his feet, and so is the Fijian.
Well, I've been on the end of big hits from both of these sides, Nigel, and I tell you, it's amazing how they manage to get themselves back up sometimes, because it's like being run over by a bus.
7 points to 5 with the Samoan conversion attempt coming from Lola Lui out wide. And after that little fracas, everyone's calmed down a bit. Everyone's back on their feet. This is Lola Lui from the touchline. It's pulling across the face of the post, and it stays a 2-point difference. 2 minutes to go in this.
Captain, please.
And we're not a million miles away from the airport. It's all right, it's not landing here.
Guys, it's a good game of rugby. Can we just play rugby, not nothing else, please? Can we have a chat for you guys? Focus on the game. Cheers.
Well, the tension out there on the field, that's for sure. Okay, referee from Wellington, New Zealand, James McPhail, had his first tournament this season in the Gold Coast, where Fiji won by professional, a civil engineer. Well, very civil referee is too. Nicely tucked down by Thakau. Setapano Thakau piles in now.
Hold on.
Ball held too long. Lola Lui switches it to Samoa in possession again. Here's the great playmaker, Uali Mai. Man who's played more tournaments than anyone else in the history of the game. Set up now by Fao Saliva. Into the hands of Ayono.
The line speed in defence.
Time's off.
Good recovery there from the Samoans and getting the ball back and looking after the ball well.
Well, they know who they will meet in the Cup semi-final. Whoever goes through, it's England. With that narrow win over South Africa.
Okay, time on.
Nayef Thalebu still looking a little bit
crouch.
Bruised from that
touch.
Last tackle.
Pause.
Fiji put in. Just about half a minute to play in this first half. Falls to Talibula, but up quickly is Fao Saliva. It's all on the bounce here. Fao Saliva can't get the touchdown.
Nothing here.
Well, this man in his 37th tournament has been a revelation this season. Really has taken the grasp of the forward trio with 125 tries to his name and nearly 136.
He can move for a big guy there. So close, unlucky. I mean, there were key passage of play here now as well, right before half-time.
So what's he going to do? Well, Ali Mai's got the put in front of the post. What's he going to do?
Well, look, he's got options both ways, and it depends on how the ball comes out. If it comes out queenly, like Ali Mai, loves the little scoot to try and draw the players in and put his winger out wide.
Or sometimes has a man as a decoy. He doesn't this time. It's a Tupu. Tupu with a little switch. Going through to Lola Lui. Has he grounded it? It's given. It's given, and Samoa take the lead.
It's good for what they're great at doing, Nigel, is they hold the ball up well, and they really leave the switch play till the last minute. Lala Lui just let the guy go, draw the defenders, and at the right time, bang, he puts the pace on back against the ball, and there he's got enough there to stretch over the line, and that's a big plus for Samoa there, getting that try right on the death of half time.
10 points to 7. He did well there and managed to, well, he knew where he was, he knew where to put the ball down. This is the man who scored the try, Lola Lui. But not on target, but still initiative with Samoa at half-time.
Uncharacteristic of him there with the boot.
Well, he's
spot on.
So supporters all around the world for Fiji and for Samoa. So the new coach there, Faamoni Lalomilo, who was team manager when Samoa won the overall title 09-10, taking over from Steve Beagle. Something about the Samoa team is they love to play the big teams, and it's amazing how much they raise their game, because you saw them playing some games yesterday in France. The quality wasn't there, but they bring their A game out against the big times, and I thought, though, that having played with England, the battles we used to have with Samoa were incredible.
Well, he used to be pretty mobile as an international back row forward. A little bit heavy for that now, I would say. Lalomilo. Alafaretti there, you saw. The man who says, attack is our watchword. The former captain himself of the Fiji Sevens. Just 3 points in it. And so much at stake for these two great Sevens nations.